NSW, what are some dirty secrets you have seen at a bachelorette party that could ruin the marriage? Two of the three bachelor parties I've been to were pretty vanilla. Drinks, grill, video games. Of course, one of those omitted the drinks because Jesus. The third, however, was more fun. So turns out the groom and one of the groom's men were lovers at one point, completely unbeknownst to the rest of the world. The groomsman, Chris, decides that tonight was the optimal time to tell the groom, Harris, that he loved him. That he's always loved him since the first time they kissed however long ago. The rest of us just sat there in stunned silence. Right there in my living room, they have this huge argument about how Harris wasn't gay and how Chris said he was okay with just being occasional frick bros for the last 5 years, but they both knew it had to end when he got engaged. Finally, it devolved into an actual fist fight and they both ended up with some nasty bruises. We broke it up eventually, but sometimes you just have to let out your physical frustration with your gay lover the night before he gets married. It's one of those weird things though. After it was over and they both calmed down, they just gave a big hug and that was that. Next morning, Harris' dad is obviously curious why he has a black eye. We'd agreed to say paintball to everyone and that was the official story. Chris had a bruise too, but he's really black so you couldn't tell that much. Harris' sister used some concealer or something on his eye and the wedding went off without a hitch. Harris is still married to his wife and Chris is still his best friend. So all's well that ends well, I suppose. The bit about gay fisticuffs made me think this was going in a completely different direction than it did. Not a party but the rehearsal dinner. Groom's father reaches out and grabs a handful of bride-to-be's butt. She turns around and he sticks his hand up her skirt and up her crotch. She quickly jumps back, surprised and upset. Then she responds with, "Stop it. You are going to make me blush." His son came over and both his dad and fiancé acted as if nothing. How did we find out about this? We watched the video the photographer took of that night. Yeah, update. You all are wondering what happened after. The wedding went on as planned. The couple made it past a year, not much, before calling it quits. There is no indication they saw the video. The guy and his dad have a great relationship, so I am guessing. No, they did not see the video or they are just that weird. Like a lot of you, I too wonder why none of his or friends who say the video spoke up. I put my money on the affair camp. I would not be surprised if anything was going on between the guy's father and the bride. That is what makes sense to me. Welp. From this thread I learned that if I'm cheated on, nobody will tell me. I worked in a photo lab. Normally it was cats and houses in the pics. But then a woman dropping off a few rolls of film was acting oddly. This is usually a clear sign that the pictures were going to be interesting. It was a bachelorette party. Normal stuff at first. The women were all fairly pretty. Then a safari themed stripper was being featured. The pictures show most of the women at the party blowing the stripper. Then the stripper got the bride practically naked in a circle of them and dry humped her in several ways, rubbing his junk all over her. Then the pics were in a bedroom. The bride and another girl made love to the stripper. My guess was they were alternating who was taking pictures. The last photo was a cum shot on the ring. The last photo was a cum shot on the ring. Oh, that's low. What a freaking psychotic crap bloom of a bride. In New Orleans, our bachelor group good found a bachelorette group and started talking, dancing, etc. It was late in the night at this time, and our bachelor was dancing with their bachelorette mostly at the urging of the bridesmaids because they thought it would be cute. Not too long into it, he gets belligerently handsy and heads a bit up the skirt. I didn't see the act but spun around when one of the bridesmaids hollered, "Your bachelor just fingered our bachelorette." We bounced immediately. In New Orleans. Nuff said. Not a traditional bachelor party, but upon going out for drinks with him, the groom spent an uncomfortable amount of time voicing very real, foundational concerns about the union, his then fiancée, their terrible money situation. It was about 2 months prior to the wedding, and, in his own words, he wouldn't call it off because people had already bought their tickets and stuff. It was all around depressing because, on the actual day, she seemed pretty happy and he just looked kinda flat. A look that seems to be a permanent fixture in his demeanor these days. I think he was just too polite to initially call it off when he realized he wasn't 100% into it. And then it progressed into cohabitation, engagement, marriage. My bachelor party was a complete shitshow. By poetic coincidence, my best man was going through a divorce while things were ramping up toward my wedding. When I arrived at his place for the party, I found him sitting on the living room floor. On the floor, because, you see, there wasn't any furniture. His wife had come while he was at work, and cleaned out the house. Like, thoroughly cleaned it out. No furniture, no glasses in the kitchen, no curtains. She left his clothes, still folded, in the place where the dresser used to be. In the closet, his clothes were on the floor. She'd taken the hangers, the booze he'd stocked up for the party, all gone. Except for one empty bottle, left in the otherwise barren fridge. She took the mustard, even, barren. He sat on the floor, shell-shocked and stunned. Occasionally he'd answer a question in monotone grunts. The other guys arrived, and some of them brought a couple six-packs of beer. We all sat on the floor in the living room, occasionally tossing bottle caps at an empty bottle in the center of the room. If it hit, it'd make a ting noise, and we'd all give a Monty Python yay. At one point, one of us found a deck of cards in a pile of random stuff she'd decided she didn't want, and had thrown into a corner of the dining room. We threw cards at the target bottle for a while, until another friend made a discovery. She'd taken all the hearts, leaving only the spades, clubs, and diamonds. Best man started weeping. I'd managed to drink two beers. We'd told a few half-hearted stories and largely spent the night trying to convince the best man he was better off this way. Most of the guys left, and I stayed until the wee hours of the morning with the best man wailing, "Don't do it, man. It isn't worth it." Good times. She'd taken all the hearts, leaving only the spades, clubs, and diamonds. That's cold. I was on a bachelor party that ended horribly when his fiancée learned he had been cheating on her for the entire first half of their relationship. She called off the marriage over the phone with him while we were all getting drunk at a bar. Mood went from lighthearted to catastrophic in an instant, and none of his friends knew about it, so consoling him was really hard, since he was so clearly in the wrong. I've been to one bachelor party, my brother's. It was three guys, the groom, the best man, and me, sitting around a campfire shooting the crap and drinking whiskey. Of course, the wedding was put together in less than a week, so obviously there wasn't time to plan anything extravagant. Before you ask, no, it wasn't a shotgun wedding. The bride was diagnosed with terminal cancer. Not only did she want to experience a wedding while she could, they wanted to make sure he was her next of kin before the inevitable. Good thing they did, too. Her parents tried to go against her wishes in pretty much every way possible. For instance, she insisted on no viewing and being cremated, because she wanted people to remember her how she was when she was healthy. Her parents demanded an open casket. My brother told them in no uncertain terms to frick themselves. Whoa, that's amazing. And props to your brother. I sincerely hope he's doing well. Went to a friend's bachelor party as a DD. Everyone was very drunk. Groom decided to make love to the best man in the middle of a public parking lot. This was when we realized he liked men. Needless to say, his now wife still doesn't know he likes to make love to men. One time at a bachelorette party, I found out that the bride was a lesbian and didn't want to get married, but she was doing it because her parents liked her fiancé and they were really good friends. So she thought the marriage would be okay. I don't know if she ever told her husband about that, but they did end up divorcing later. Right around the time my brother-in-law-to-be was drunk enough to get maudlin, his friends and I duct taped him to a tree. Specifically, the tree he'd be getting married under about 16 hours later. I will definitely not be having my bachelor party the night before the wedding. My friend screwed a stripper at his bachelor party. We bought him a lap dance and he disappeared for about an hour. Apparently he paid a little extra and had some more fun. My ex-girlfriend said she fricked a whole bachelor party in Vegas a few years ago. She also said that there was video somewhere that one of the guys took. She is half Japanese and half Filipina, about 5 feet tall, and skinny yet fit, and was wearing a blue dress for you Reddit detectives that want to try to find it. I attended an old college friend's bachelor party. Worst that happened that night was he got a lap dance. His fiancée knew about that, allegedly. Couple of weeks later, I am out getting a few drinks with another group of friends. We have too many drinks and think it's a great idea to go to this scummy dive bar. Think the kind of place the Always Sunny gang would find homely. But lo and behold, he was there in a shady booth, inspecting the tonsils of a vintage Walmart ham beast. He is clearly wasted and doesn't see me. I get another drink, figuring I will get up the nerve to do something. Spoiler alert, I do jack crap. He leaves with a girl after performing a digital cervical inspection of his prize for the evening. No idea what happened that night. He lived with his fiancée, but a couple of weeks later I get an email saying the wedding is off. Still friends with both of them on Facebook, but yeah, they are not together anymore. Your descriptions are magical. Bachelor drunk texted his ex when the party started winding down. Got back to where we were staying and he ended up sending obscene texts to her for hours. Sending pictures and all that crap. Apparently it happened a few more times after the wedding. 2. I know of a couple that are together because the girl got pregnant. I also know who the father is. Hint, not the person she married. The guy who was the father was there at her version of a bachelorette party. He was her best friend, so he threw her a private party, like 5 of us. I was there for the first little bit as a close friend, but things heated up so I got the hint and bounced. The one good thing you can do now is telling the husband so he can have the chance of an honest life. Dang, I really never get woman who can let her husband raise another man's child without him knowing the child's not his. One of the craziest nights of my life. There was 9 of us. 5 of us were all buddies since elementary school, high school, inc. groom, and the other 4 were our more friends of the groom, but we all know each other at least a little bit. We go to the strip club and everyone is having a great time, nothing out of the ordinary or over the top until this chick we knew from high school gets on the stage. I partied with her a few times in HS and didn't really know her all that well. She totally digs the fact that we are there, so she gives us a little extra attention, and once she was done on stage she took a few of the boys to the private showing room. Not me. Sometime as the night is going on, one of the boys convince her to come back to the house we were going to afterwards. Little did I know at the time that one of the groom's friends had some blow, so it wasn't very hard to convince her. We get back to the house and everyone is pretty drunk. The guy with the blow and the stripper are in a room for a while, and after she comes out she is ready to give every guy a turn. We found out after that Mr. Blow told her she could have his bag if he hooked up with everyone at the party. The groom passed. One of my HS buddies went next and I was 3rd. Unfortunately, I don't remember everything as great detail because I was drunk and high. Herb not Blow. But the stripper gave me a wicked lap dance and then I just got a BJ. Not long after that I passed out for the night, but every guy except for the groom and one other married guy got something from the stripper. 2 guys tag teamed her and got it on video. Haven't seen it. And she left with Mr. Blow at like 5 a.m. B stole my herb after I passed out, but for the amount I had and getting a free BJ it wasn't too bad of a trade-off, lol. The groom passed. Every guy except for the groom and one other married guy. Those 2 bits made me really like this story. I'm all for a party, but hate the idea of married dudes or the groom using stag parties as an excuse to cheat. It. Stripper freaking. A lot of stripper freaking, but also a surprising amount of groom actually likes men. This happened a couple of years ago. Cousin was having his bachelor's party, but the guys got stuck with the kids so that the ladies could go crazy with their bachelorette party. So it was just pizza and Marvel movie marathon for the party. Next day I get a message saying that there will be a real bachelor party tonight to make up for getting stuck babysitting kids. This turns into a typical drink fest. Gambling, GF wife ranting, etc. The cousin's friend then announces that he hired a stripper just as the doorbell rang. Turns out the stripper was my cousin's ex-GF of 3 years. So she starts doing her stripper routine, which was not that great emo. Clearly not a professional. She spends most of the time dancing for my cousin, which I could tell was a clear bet you wish you kept me. So she's finally done with her performance and goes to leave, but offers a more private performance for the groom. And since the groom had a few too many shots, he agrees and both head to the bathroom. All the while all the guys are hooting them on. 4 years later I see his ex at the grocery store with a little girl that looked to be 3 or 4 years old. I just turn around to avoid her seeing me. Head to the cashier, grabbed my stuff, and just ran. I never dare tell him since he and his wife are in a happy relationship and trying to have a child together. first bachelor party when I was 18 and worked in a summer role at a petroleum engineering company. My colleagues were all young engineers in their 20s earning the big bucks. We went to the house where the party was and was handed a drink and a door prize number. We went down the stairs into the basement, and the first room had the groom tied to a chair with a drip of some rum drink going into his mouth. The TV had VHSP on it. This was back then. In came strippers, which proceeded to use their breasts to facet paint all the participants. After a while, some of the girls left, while the others did the traditional groom tied to a chair and having a lap dance process. Turns out the door prize was one of the strippers. I assumed that all bachelor parties would be similar. I can say, now, 35 years later, no. That's not when things get wild, it's more likely to be an after work gathering with other employees and alcohol. Ah. Holiday office parties. Nothing stopped the one where someone got stabbed, another got physically abused, our CEO was nearly arrested and two marriages ended all in one night. Fun times. I was part of a bachelor party that was strip club hopping in Vegas. The bachelor went back for a private dance. The club has these little rooms with really small beds for private dances. We suddenly see the stripper, holding her outfit pressed against her chest, running to the behind the stage area while a large bouncer is escorting the bachelor out. At the same time, another club employee informed us that the bachelor had to leave. We could stay if we wanted to, but he had to leave. Of course we all left, but he would not tell us any details of what happened. I still talk to the guy and to this day he won't say a word on what went on back there. We all have our theories. Was invited to a bachelor party once. We played so much Smash Bros and ate so much pizza, I don't know how he made it to the wedding in the morning. My god. I don't know if the marriage would survive if the bride found out how much we drank. It must have been at least half a gallon of soda. The stripper got his dong sucked by the bride-to-be. Actually, aside from the bachelorette party, I'm surprised she hasn't cheated on him. Her glory hole is a free spirit. A good friend of mine made out with a groom on his stag party in Nick all the way from Ireland. He wanted to come all the way back with us. I feel bad for his bride. She didn't know he was on his stag party until about 15 minutes into the making out. I had a bachelor party in Las Vegas. It was amazing, everyone had a great time. Except I was never engaged, my buddy made up the story so he could go to Vegas and bang H. I was filled in about 10 minutes before we sat down to a dinner his wife was attending. I got really drunk with the groom and I was the best man. We slept together that night. No lovemaking. We just cuddled. Nothing like a bro cuddle. No homo. Just saw that a bachelorette party can lie somewhere between the extremes of bowling alley plus Wendy's versus hooking up with strippers. Believe it or not, you can have an appropriate amount of fun and crazy without ruining the marriage. My now wife and I had our respective bachelorette parties in Vegas, and we both had a great time. She went to a couple day clubs with her girls and also went to Chippendales. Got blackout drunk with her best friend taking care of her. And they have some hilarious stories from their adventures. My groomsmen and I pulled out. One of my close friends is rich and got us tables. I got a couple of my groomsmen laid, and someone almost got arrested for public urination. Great fun, but nothing I wouldn't joke about with my better half. Obviously, if you don't trust the other person to party without cheating on you, don't let them do that. But then at that point maybe reevaluate your decision to marry them. Just trying to provide some perspective here for anyone panicking after reading some of the stories. I heard from my wife that at my sister-in-law's bachelorette party the male stripper did this move where he flipped her over and she landed really hard on her back. Between the drinking and loose environment everybody just sort of laughed it off. She was actually a few months pregnant at the time and when she had my nephew, he was born with some pretty serious learning disabilities. I don't think my brother even knew there was a stripper there, let alone that that happened. Comma drinking. Comma pregnant. Comma born with learning disabilities. Think that has more to do with it than anything. Not a bachelor party but a golf tournament weekend with a bunch of people from our office. A girl I worked with just went wild. Got drunk and was giving lap dances. Flashing. Letting guys put money in her panties. Etc. She later disappeared into the woods with two separate guys and was making out in a bar with another later in the evening. I had known her for a few years and had never seen any inclination for that type of behavior out of her. Monday at work, I talked with her and she was beside herself with guilt. I didn't tell her husband or anyone else about the weekend. Pretty sure her marriage would have been over if he had found out about it at the time, but this was at least 13-14 years ago. I think the only thing that saved her was that this was before the time of Snapchat, Twitter, etc. No way her behavior wouldn't have been documented today. You have been visited by the romantic doggo. Comment "love is magic" so you never fall in the friend zone. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Or don't. Either way, have a great day, you magnificent people.